Thank you, Lord. Why don't you put your hands together for the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings. We love you, Jesus. We thank you. We praise you. Amen. Thank God. Well, what a wonderful evening to be in the house of God. Amen. To feel His presence again. Amen. I sure don't feel worthy of what we're feeling, but I'll sure take it. Amen. Thank God. Amen. For His faithfulness and His goodness. Amen. Our prayers are for all those that are sick tonight and traveling, working, sleeping, skipping. Amen. Wherever everybody is, we pray for everybody. So thankful that the Chancellor sisters are out of jail. Amen. No, she hadn't been in jail. Man, you would think some employers think they run a jail. Amen. But I tell you something about living for God. He'll bless you. Amen. He'll turn a bad situation into something good. He'll turn Egypt into a miracle. Well, ain't it a good life living for the Lord? Hallelujah. Thank God. Thank God. Thank God. Amen. It's so good to have Carrie Compton here with us. Thank you for being here tonight. Amen. Sister Kathy's family here. God bless them. Thank y'all for being here. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Didn't these singers, musicians do a wonderful job tonight? Thank the Lord. Praise God. Well, I'm just going to keep preaching. What I started to preach this morning, the Lord just keeps dealing with me about it. Amen. I always want to obey the Holy Ghost. Amen. He knows right where you're at. Amen. Just think about 100 plus people. You know what that means? 100 plus different scenarios and lives and situations and things that need to be said. And God knows it all. Amen. So I'm just going to keep trusting Him. He knows what's best. Amen. Thank God. Thank God for the Holy Ghost. Thank God when I got ready to repent, there was a church that was still praying. Hallelujah. For many years, I did not want to live for God, but it did my heart good to go back to church and know that there was still a people that were going to be in that building praying. Hey, it put comfort in my heart to know there was going to be somewhere I could go. Amen. Thank God for the church. Thank God for the old time paths. Thank God for people that said, I'm going to pray until they come home. Thank God for mamas and wives that say, I'm going to keep praying till God yanks them up out of where they're at. Brings them to an altar. My Lord, I feel more determined tonight. Amen. I feel like encouraging some mamas and grandmas and grandpas right now. Your prayers ain't falling on deaf ears. God ain't deaf. His arm ain't short. Just keep praying. Keep believing. Amen. I like that song that says, even when I can't see it, He's working. Praise God. We're not walking by sight. If we were, we would be discouraged sometimes. Amen. But thank God we're walking by faith. Faith says if God said I'm healed, I'm going to be healed. Faith said if God told me anything I ask in His name, I could have it. Praise God, it's mine. That's what faith says. Hallelujah. Come on, let's love Jesus right now. Hallelujah. We love you, Jesus. We love you, Jesus. We love you, Jesus. We love you, Jesus. Hallelujah. If you got your Bibles, open them to Luke, the 19th chapter. I'm just going to read the 8th, 8th, 9th, and 10th verse. I believe if I can figure this out. Luke, the 19th chapter. Amen. And Zacchaeus stood and said unto the Lord, Behold, Lord, the half of my goods I give to the poor. And if I have taken anything from any man by false accusation, I restore him fourfold. And Jesus said unto him, This day, everybody say this day. This day is salvation come to this house. Praise God. What a day. What a happy day when salvation comes to your house. Woo! For so much as he also is a son of Abraham. For the Son of Man has come to seek and to save that which was lost. Amen. Was lost. Amen. Praise God. I want to keep preaching the faith of Zacchaeus. I need some prayer warriors to lift your hands. Lift your voices. Come on, cry out to God right now. Come on, lift up your voice, church. Do you want God to help you tonight? Come on, do you want God to take you to a new level in this place? Hallelujah. We love you, Jesus. 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 Hallelujah. One more time, put your hands together. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We're in love with you, God. We're thankful tonight, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. You can be seated. Thank you for standing. Amen. I just felt like the Lord wanted me to keep preaching from this title about the faith of Zacchaeus. Amen. I have been preaching about faith for quite some time. It's like the Lord has been dealing with me about this particular subject. And I don't know, maybe 6 months ago when the Lord began to really deal with my spirit about the scripture that said that he mentioned, when I return, will there be any faith left on the earth? Amen. And when you began to look around at our world, you realize that people have very little faith in the things of God. They have very little faith in the Word of God. They have very little faith in church and the preached Word of God anymore. But you let a government organization begin to make recommendations, and you begin to figure out where people's faith really is. Amen. I'm not throwing things at anybody. I'm preaching the gospel tonight. Amen. That it's time that we get our eyes off of humanity, and get our eyes off of government, and get our eyes back on the Bible. And get our eyes and our faith back in God that brought the children of Israel out of Egypt. Amen. Let me tell you, the government ain't going to take you to the promised land. But the God of Israel, if you'll trust him and if you'll believe him and you'll obey him, he'll carry you out of here. My God, I feel the Holy Ghost already in this place. If we ever needed to trust God in 2020, we need to trust God. Come on, church, help me right now. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Amen. The Bible said faith cometh by hearing, and hearing comes by the Word of God. Amen. I feel like preaching to you, God is still in control. I said God is still in charge in 2020, and if something happens to you, God allowed it to happen to you. Amen. People start letting their faith go down. Well, I got sick. I don't know how this happened. God must not love me. Let me tell you something. God knows how to try his people. Let me tell you a little story about three Hebrews. Hebrew children that ended up in a fiery furnace. Do you believe that God did not love them? I rebuke that line of thought. God wanted to show who he really was. I'm telling you, God wants to work a miracle in the middle of a trial. God wants to work miracles in the middle of a pandemic. God wants to set people free. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. My Lord, I feel Jesus in this place. Amen. The blessings of God doesn't necessarily represent the favor of God. Praise God. There was a man named Cyrus who had everything that God anointed him, that God blessed him, that God used him. But the Bible said he did not know who I am. Praise God. I don't know what you're seeking tonight. Amen. Maybe you want a dollar an hour raise. Amen. But I ain't looking for a dollar an hour. I'm looking to touch Jesus one more time. Amen. $1 an hour ain't going to fix your problems. Amen. It's just going to make them worse probably. But one Holy Ghost prayer meeting will set you free. One Holy Ghost prayer meeting, Brother Thomas, will give you the faith. We'll give you the joy back. I'll take this whole world, but give me Jesus.
Take this whole world, but give me Jesus. Take this whole world, but give me Jesus. Take this whole world, but give me Jesus. I won't turn back. I won't turn back. Oh, take this whole world, but give me Jesus. Take this whole world, but give me Jesus. Take this whole world, but give me Jesus. I won't turn back. I won't turn back.
Hallelujah. Clap your hands to the Lord together. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Thank you, God. My, feels like we're sitting on a powder keg of anointing in this place. Oh, I feel God's going to do miracles before we get out of here. God's already done miracles in this house. God did miracles here in prayer meeting. If you miss prayer meeting, you miss the first miracles that happened. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Man, because of the faith of Zacchaeus, because he was willing to overcome some obstacles, he got God's attention. When he got God's attention, God said, I'm going to go to your house today. Let me tell you what happens when sinners and Jesus get together. In the 8th verse, it tells us, Zacchaeus stood and said unto the Lord, Behold, Lord, the half of my goods I give to the poor. And if I have taken anything from any man by false accusation, I restore him fourfold. Oh, I feel like preaching. You know what happens when you bring sinners to the house? And they come in contact with Jesus. The natural response is they just start repenting. Jesus wasn't preaching to that man. He just said, I'm going to your house. We think we got to have everything figured out. Well, before they get here. Boy, this one's going to be a difficult one, Pastor. Before they get there, I want to make sure that you're preaching from this chapter. And I want to make sure they sing that song. And I want to make sure everything's just right. you can't get it right. Your humanity. But let me tell you who can get it right. Jesus can get it right. If we'll just show up, if we'll just show up and start entertaining the presence of God, people will start repenting. Oh, yes, Lord. Hallelujah. I was preaching dear lady's funeral, Sister Sharon Winningham, Sister Tana's mother, a few weeks ago. I don't know how long ago it was. And Sister Tana said, just preach. Hey, man, they're going to need to hear what you got to say. In other words, we're going to get them in church one time. Just go ahead and don't hold anything back. Don't sugarcoat it. You just, we're going to have them here. Guess what I started doing? I started preaching about a new birth. The first time you was born, it wasn't right. You wasn't ready to meet God. You were born in sin, shaping an iniquity. But God provided us a second birth, that if you'll come to an altar and you'll repent of your sins and be baptized in Jesus' name, God will fill you with the Holy Ghost. Now, I'm talking about at a funeral. I ain't talking about Sunday night church. I'm talking about a funeral. Guess what happens at the end of the funeral? Her brother's over on the second row, boo-hooing his eyes out, repenting of his sin. He's probably watching right now, saying, hey, I want to live for God. Hey, we don't need less Holy Ghost. We need more Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Praise. Let's pray for them right now. They may be watching on the internet. BJ, God's going to fill you with the Holy Ghost. God, you bless him right now. Wrap your arms around him. Comfort him, Lord. Let him feel the peace that passeth all understanding, Lord.